Action time. So, today we are going to study work and energy, our practice test. Let's start with our first question. People, as you know, you have seven definitions, seven terms for class test, for this class test. Number one was energy, ability to do work. And then number two, potential energy. Number three, kinetic energy. And then number four, mechanical energy. Okay, let's explain them all. Energy, ability to do work. In your scope, you have all details, people. Number two is potential energy. Energy of position, you can say. Energy of position. And the number three, kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is energy of motion. And then what else we have, people? Mechanical energy, sum of potential and kinetic. Conservation of mechanical energy, we should know. Total mechanical energy remains constant in a closed system. Please write. Today you are going to mark your paper also. I will tell you what, how you are going to answer questions and how you are going to mark. And then people, energy, conservation of energy. And another one, energy remains constant in a closed system. Mechanical energy or just energy is the same thing. And then people, another one is work. Work is transfer of energy by acting a force on an object. This is work. Please try to know all definitions out of seven, three terms we are asking you people. All right, six marks coming from these terms. Okay, question 1.1. The law of conservation of mechanical energy, 2 marks question. So please check your answer, people. Because the mechanical energy remains constant in a closed system, or you can say in a system. If you say system, closed system, 1 mark, remains constant, another mark, please check your answer. And then you can give 2 marks if everything is fine. For kinetic energy, you are gonna say energy of motion. If you say energy of motion, you can give 2 marks. You can just mark with 2. Mechanical energy, sum of potential and kinetic energy. Sum of potential and kinetic energy. That's it. So 6 marks total. I hope everything is fine. I'm not writing down all definitions because you have already in your scope. I will just show you end of period also. We are going to work all 7 of them together. But to mark your paper, I think it's fine. 6 marks. Mechanical energy remains constant in a closed system. And the kinetic energy is the energy of motion. Mechanical energy, total, sum of potential and kinetic. That's it. Question 2. Okay, let's answer question 2 with you now. I'm answering, and then if you have any question. Okay, your test on Monday. On Monday, online, just like our practice test, but I couldn't check if you submit all or not. I'm going to check. So your test, Monday, first lesson. Monday, first lesson, because online learners are joining on first lesson Monday. That's our test date. Okay, so now this is our question, people. Today, let's try to finish all questions. And then on Saturday, we have final revision before class test, people. We are gonna have our final revision. Today, let's try to finish our test. Okay, now, question 2, 3 marks question. If you write formula from formula box, you know already, they ask calculate potential energy, EP equals M times G times H. M times G times H. M is mass in kgs. And then, not ExamNet. You are using Google Classroom. Just you are writing down on your exam pad or on your notebooks. You are writing on your notebooks or on your exam pad, and then please share with me on Google Classroom. You must submit on Google Classroom. That's our plan, people. All right, not ExamNet. ExamNet doesn't work for now. I think it's clear. All right. Potential energy, M times G times H, mass in kg, please don't forget it. And then G, it is constant number, 9.8, H is height. So this is our formula, M, G, H. Now we can calculate it. So 3 kgs, it's okay. It is in kg, we can use it. But people, if you see something like this, 300 G, or something, if you unit G, you must convert to kg by divide by 1000. Okay, please remember that. If you see other units, you must convert to kg. G is constant number, people. 9.8. G is 9.8 meters per second square, people. And then height is also given, 5. As you see, it is easy question. Formula is given already. End of textbook, you can find it. And then just, people, what is important point? Units. So in your test, maybe you are going to see different units, people. For example, it's going to be G. If it is G, from G to kg, please remember, I see the too many learners, they are doing mistake for this one. It's easy one, but by mistake using hundreds, by mistake using maybe multiplied by 1000. So doing some mistakes, please remember from G to kg, divide by 1000, and then from centimeter to meter, divide by 100. So remember this, centimeter, 2 meter, divide by 100, 100, and then from G to kg, divide by 1000. All right, please remember this. Okay, now we can carry on, people. Let's calculate. Can you please calculate for me? Just calculate 3 times 9.8 times 5. What are we getting? Maybe I can calculate also here, but if you calculate, it's gonna be much better. You can join, you can do something. Otherwise today only I'm answering questions. But you did try already. Yes, 147, thank you very much. Answer is 147. 147 joules. Okay, another important point, people, units. I was checking trial test, not online learners in the class. So I was just checking some learners, they are forgetting joules. So joules or whatever, what is unit you have, what you are calculating. If you don't write unit, you are losing your 1 mark, people. Out of 3, just 1 mark is gone. Just think about that. I think one learner, she was just using 5 marks, I think, because of this unit. So please, people, please be careful about units. You must just convert, or you must just write your unit. If you are calculating energy, unit is joules. If you are calculating potential energy, kinetic energy, mechanical energy, even work, all of them, same unit. All right, same unit, please remember. This letter is giving you how many marks? So for each question, maybe 3-4 marks coming from this unit. Please, people, remember to write units. Easy question, yes, but if you forget about units, if you are using wrong units, so you are gonna lose your marks. Okay, I think it is clear, question 2. We can go to next question. Find, calculate the kinetic energy of a 4 kg object moving at speed of 10 meters per second, just on top, let's fix it. 10 meters per second, negative one is here. So this question, yes, answer is there. Thank you very much. From our learners, answer is coming. We are gonna calculate together now. If you share your answer with me, it's gonna be perfect, people, because if you try, you are gonna learn, you know that. Today we have more than 30 learners. I don't know what's gonna happen during test. I hope you are gonna join, you're gonna come to school. Okay, find the kinetic energy. Formula is Ek equals half mass and V square. If you say it is easy for you, you can write like this also, people. MV square over 2. This is second option, same thing. Now we are writing our numbers, all givens, 4, it is kg, P please people, for each question, just make sure your units okay. Just as you see, it is kg, yes, no problem, we can use it. And then meters per second, it's okay. If you see kilometer per hour, maybe you different units, you have to convert this one also. You know already, right? From meters per second to kilometer per hour. But in this test, we are not asking anyway. Okay, so 4 times 10, but another problem, people forgetting this too. Just writing 10, 4 times 10 is 40, divided by 2 is 20, and then your answer is wrong. But we have 10 square, 10 square here. Please remember, just don't forget it, okay? And then getting 400 over 2, answer is 200 joules. That's it. This is our question 3. Easy questions, taking time, but just, I know, just we are doing slowly. Why? Because people, I see too many mistakes. People forgetting units, people just not writing correct unit, not using correct unit. Please, people, be careful, all right? Okay, let's continue with next question. If you don't have any question here, but how you are gonna mark, let's explain. Formula, 1 mark for each, these 3 marks about formula, potential or kinetic, and you are writing down. And then this solution, all givens, when you write, you are getting another mark for these steps. Finally, correct answer with correct unit, 1 mark. If there's no unit, if you forget it, just don't give full mark, people, to yourself. Okay, that's our question 2 and 3. Done. Let's continue. Number 4 now. Okay, this question, they are asking you, people, calculate the total mechanical energy for 150 g. Yes, units we have to convert. And then people, kinetic energy is given. Speed is not given, but kinetic energy is given. But in your test, I'm planning to give you speed also. You are gonna have speed, but you will not have kinetic energy directly. You have to calculate. All right, maybe on Saturday we can answer that kind of questions also for final revision. Okay, let's go. Okay, now we are answering this question. First of all, people, from formula box, you can get this one. EM equals EP plus EK. And then potential energy formula, you know. Potential energy formula. Yes, it is 0.15 kg, you are right, because divide by 1,000. Divide by 1,000, I will just convert it now. Formula, potential energy M times G times H, plus formula of kinetic energy 1/2 mass and V square. But for now, we don't need this formula, people. We are gonna use it directly, 30 joules. Okay, first of all, we should convert this unit. Mass equals 150/1,000, 0.15 kg. So we have to just convert it first. This is our first thing to do. And then unit of height already in meters. We don't have to touch it. So just use it. So 0.15 times 9.8. In your test, you will have this constant number, people. In formula box, in practice test, I couldn't share, but in your classes, you are gonna have it. And then height is 4 plus 30. I'm writing 30 because already given, kinetic energy already given directly, we are using it. So next one, we are just calculating all. Can you please, I think you shared or not yet. Can you please share your answer with me? What is your answer? What did you get? 35.88. Thank you very much. 35.88 units joules. That's it. This is our question, people. So this question may be, we'll have maybe 5 marks, 4 or 5 marks, because converting, we have to give mark also. If I give G and then centimeters, so it's gonna be 5 marks, this question. Okay, so I'm just planning something like that. Please know that, please just study converting. Please remember, how can we convert from G to kg and from centimeters to meters? So this question or other question, but you will have converting, all right. Okay, So let's continue with next question. I think we don't have to wait to write these questions. Easy questions you have done already. Now, next question, number five. Yes, problems start from here. Number five and six. Okay, number seven also okay, because easy one. But number five and six, unfortunately, you couldn't get it. Most of learners, they are lost about this. Not most of learners, some learners, we can say. Some learners, they are lost about this question. Number five and six, I will try to just give diagram also during your test. I will just give diagram for these two questions. Diagram will be like this. For example, first one, okay, let's draw now here. Just let's read our question, what they said, this system. Okay, so we have this diagram. During test, you will have it. All right, just something like this. First position, we have, but we have 15 centimeters height, 15 centimeters. And then they said object coming to second position. So object coming here. And then, as you know, people, first position, there is no speed because someone holding it, we can say something holding it. So V equals zero, but it is not given, people. But they said released from position at centimeters. Just they said released from. So just you should get from question, people, it is zero. Okay, first position, speed is zero because it's when it's coming here, just like highest point, you can say. So when question six, you will see object is going up. So now it is zero, speed is zero. If speed is zero, potential is zero, just know that we have height for first position. And then second position, okay, let's draw like this. Second position, height is zero. Object is before touching, just coming here, just touch, but not touching. Okay, almost touching this side. So height is zero now for two, height is zero. If you know for each position, which one is zero, speed or height, if you know that, it is easy to calculate, people. All right. If you know which one is zero, speed or height, so easy to calculate after that, because we are going to cancel potential or kinetic for each position. All right. So formula is EM1 equals EM2. In your formula box, you never see this one, EM1 equals EM2. You should know that from conservation of mechanical energy. But you will have EM equals EP plus EK, but you will not have EM1 equals EM2. You should know that. So this kind of questions, people, we are starting with our friends. I'm just saying them, they are our friends, because how many times we are using them, I don't know. So EM1 equals EM2, first step. Second step, we are writing for EM1, EP1 plus EK1, and then EP2 plus EK2. People, whatever they ask, step one, step two, exactly the same. Okay, question five, question six, same steps you are writing, step one, step two, same. But from now, something different. From now, people, you should check first position. What is zero? Of course, they are going to ask you some different system, people. I'm not telling you, they are asking exactly the same. So we can ask some different things, because in your final exam also they can ask different systems. But for each question, we need 2 points, 2 positions. All right, always. That one certain, nothing to do. And then step one, step two, always same for this kind of questions. From now, check your position one. As you see, they said released from position. So it means someone holding it. Someone was holding it and then leave it. If they leave it, so what's going on, people? Initial speed, let's say initial VI, initial speed is zero. If your initial speed is zero, kinetic energy is zero. Sorry, people, I'm just explaining slowly, but I saw too many people just they are lost about this question, because we are planning to get full mark, but unfortunately because of these questions, and then as you see people, 7 marks, 6, some of 5 marks, next time maybe 6 marks each, so 10, 12 marks coming from this kind of questions. So if you don't get it, so it's gonna be a problem. People, kinetic energy is zero. And then second position, as you see people, height is zero. If you have this kind of diagram, if you have diagram, it's gonna be easy for you, of course, to see which one is zero, speed or height. And then, yeah, second position, height is zero. If height is zero, potential energy is zero. From now, it is easy to calculate people. Why? Because we know potential energy is M times G times H. And then kinetic energy, 1/2 M times V squared. So for this test, one of these will be zero, potential or kinetic for first position, potential and kinetic for second position. But for final exam, they can ask different forms, maybe only kinetic is zero for first position and then nothing zero for second position. They can ask that kind of question. Okay, we have a question here for second position. Okay, how we know second or first position? What they ask, but as you see, what is speed of the ball as passed to lowest point? Okay, this is our second position. All right, second position, what you are gonna calculate? What you are gonna calculate, for example, speed. So this is your second position. First position, it's up to you people. Sometimes you can, you are gonna have, do you remember those kind of questions? Position A, and then it was going up and then going like this, some position A, B, C. So we have different position. Second position from question. It is given what they are asking you calculate. And then first position, you can choose people. All right, it's up to you. Which one is easy for you? So first position, you are gonna choose, but second position, it is given in question. I think it is clear. So as you see, they're asking lowest point. What is speed for lowest point? Because of that, you have to use second position, this one. You cannot use other positions. All right. So now, from now people, as you see in maths, you know that cancel mass. If you want, you can carry on with mass, but we don't need, just if they cancel, so let's cancel them. From now people, and then another problem people, from now, they cannot calculate, unfortunately, some learners, they cannot calculate from this point. What are we gonna do people to make it easy? Let's write all givens. Normally I'm doing like this. This is my way, but I see that one problem for people, just cross multiplication, and then I'm writing V square equals 2 times G times H, but some learners by mistake, they're writing G times H over 2 or something, just doing something else. Because of that, I'm not using this way for now. But if you want, you can use, of course, if you're okay with this. So square root 2 times 9.8 times height is oh, okay. Height is 15 centimeters. So we cannot use 15 now. We have to convert it first. Let's write 15 centimeters equals 0.15 meters because divide by 100. And mass we don't have to convert because we are not using, it's fine. So 0.15 and then our speed is 1.71. Did you share your answer with me? Not yet, can you? Yeah, okay, thank you. So 171 is correct answer, people. 171, this is our answer. It is option one, okay. Just I'm using this option. I'm using this option, people. But to make it easy, from this point, we have another option to calculate. Just let's write all givens like this. What we have, we know G is 9.8 times height is 0.15 equals V, we are gonna calculate V square over 2. I think it's much clearer like this. Okay, so let's use all options to make it easy. Some learners, they will like this one, or some learners, they like this one, but let's give both options. 9.8 times 0.15 equals, what are we getting? 147. Okay, we are getting this side 1.47 equals v square over 2 from now cross multiplication. And 147 times 2, you're getting 294. Okay, v square equals 294. And from now, square root one more time, and then v equals 1.71 meters per second. That's it. As you see, same answer you're getting. You have two options, people. This solution, so you can use this way or this way, it's up to you. Which one is easy for you? I think this is easier one because you are writing all givens this step and then just you are carrying with numbers, not with letters. Okay, this is our question 5. Let's go to question 6 and 7 because last 10 minutes we are gonna have final revision. Just one more time, we'll check our scope, what we are gonna study. On Saturday also, we are gonna carry on with revision. All right, question 6 coming now. Question 6. Now, almost same thing, but opposite. Now let's see people, let's draw our diagram first. You have an object and going up from zero height. Okay, now first position you will see height is zero. And then they ask people, what is the maximum height? Okay, so this is position for, of course it's gonna come back, but we are not using it. What's going on? Sorry. Okay. Is it working? Not yet. Ish, my right. Okay. Yes. So, people, now we are, this is our diagram. What's going on? Sorry, people. I think it's okay now. People, first of all, second position, EM2 or position 2, you can say. First of all, because last question they ask, how can we know which one is EM1, which one is EM2? EM2, this one, why? Because what is the maximum height? So we are looking for maximum height position, EM2. EM1, we can use this one. We can use first position, or when it's coming, going down, you can use this position, last position also fine, but we don't need to do that because coming back with same speed, but we know the speed here, just let's use it. 25 meters per second, and then h is zero, h initial is zero. We are looking for height for highest point, maximum height we are looking for. All right, so let's continue, let's answer with you people. EM1 equals EM2, and then EP1 plus EK1, we said same formula for first two steps, exactly same steps. And then people, EP2 plus EK2, and then what we have for first position, what is zero, people? Potential is zero because height is zero. You remember question 5, first position kinetic energy was zero, but now potential is zero. And the second position, kinetic is zero, why? If your object going up under gravitational force, speed decreasing, people, start from 25 for this question, and then going to zero. Highest point, always speed is zero, okay. After that, when it is zero, free fall. It's just coming down with free fall. So highest point speed is zero. And then people, let's write our formula. 1/2 m times v square equals m times g times h, and mass cancel each other. Now we can write our givens, people. 25 square over 2 equals 9.8 times h. So I'm using first option for this question. And then 25 square over 2, let's calculate. 25 square equals this one divided by 2. And you are getting 312.5, 9.8 h. And then 9.8 divided by 9.8 each side. You know maths, so from now, 9.8, answer is 31.88, height equals 31.88 meters. If you have objects start with 25 meters per second, if there is no air friction, people, okay, that's important point. Yes, thank you, Oh yeah, we can write 8, 9, you are right, okay, 8, 8, but because after 8 we have 7, so we can write 9, it's much better. Okay, so 31.89, this is our height, maximum height. Okay, people, if you have initial position meters per second, but what we are saying, air resistance, air friction. If there is no air friction, this all calculation, everything is okay. But if, when you go to grade 11, 12, so you are gonna, they are gonna add air friction also. Okay, please know that one also. Okay, number six, done. Formula, solution, everything, just how we are gonna mark, 5 marks, formula, and then formula for potential, kinetic, if you write everything, so you can just write full mark to yourself. So let's continue, people, with last question. This question about work. Work equals force times distance. One object you have, some object is here, and then moving with 50 newtons, and then displacement is, displacement equals 25 meters. And what we have, people, work equals force times displacement. Force is given 50 times 25. And then what are we getting? Thank you very much. 1, 2, 5, 6. Okay. 1250 joules. As you see, people, unit joules. Why? Because work is transfer of energy. Okay. So this is our last question. Let's stop sharing this one and let's continue with our scope. Okay. So last 5 minutes, people. Quickly, I will just explain everything. On Saturday, we are going to carry on with revision. I will just explain this one and you will have one more time, similar questions, people. One more time you will try before final exam. So this is your scope. And then your textbook, from your textbook, people, starting from 218 to 236, finishing with work, last topic. You are not going to pass paper questions, okay? Pass paper questions before final exam, we are gonna focus, we are gonna study. For now, just leave it. 218 to 236, work and energy, that's our topic. And then all definitions. Number one, energy is the ability to do work or anything else. Yeah, and unit you know already. Gravitational potential energy, you can say energy of position, or if you remember everything, you can write it down. But if you say energy of position, more than enough. Kinetic energy, energy of motion, you can say. This is our kinetic energy. Mechanical energy, the sum of gravitational potential energy and the kinetic energy of a system. Yes, this is important one, people, because we are calculating with mechanical energy. And then the law of conservation of energy. Energy cannot be created or destroyed. You can say, you can start with this one. It can be transformed from one type to another. Total energy in the system remains constant. If you say this, more than enough. It's much best one, this one, people. Total energy in the system, in closed system also you can say, remains constant. And then the law of conservation of mechanical energy, same thing. The total mechanical energy, now you are saying the total amount of mechanical energy in a closed system remains constant. This is our mechanical energy. And then work, for work, people, you are gonna say only this one. Work is the transfer of energy by a force acting on an object. Work is the transfer of energy by a force acting on an object. The other things not important for now, but just to understand what's going on, you can read, you can study. But in your test, if we ask this question, people, you are gonna write, you have to write transfer of energy, number one, 1 mark, by a force, because I want to see force here. Okay, people, force and transfer is two words important to write work. If you just one missing, so you cannot get full mark, 2 marks. to get full mark people, just transfer of energy and by a force, just write down everything. Work is the transfer of energy by a force acting on an object. After that, people, you see sample questions, examples on your textbook. Please study, please check. If you don't understand any question, you can just ask on WhatsApp to me anytime. And then task, we answered already all tasks. Question 4, 5, I did share solutions, everything with you also, people, on Google Classroom. Other tasks, from task 1 and 3, we did answer with you already. And then for task 3, only question 1 to 3. Check this one also, please. And then example, page 236, this one, this is for work. And lastly, people, calculations. In your practice test, as you see, people, we ask all types of questions. First one, calculate potential energy. If they ask you calculate potential energy, you are gonna choose this formula. EP equals M times G times H. And then if they ask you kinetic energy, people, 1/2 m × v² And then mechanical energy, you know, EM equals EP plus EK. So you are using these two formulas. And then if they ask you speed, formula is EM1 equals EM2. And then to calculate height, EM1 equals EM2 one more time. And then work equals force times displacement. And then people, please remember, your mass always in kgs. If you see g, don't forget to just divide by 1,000. If you see centimeter for height, divide by 100, because centimeters, it means height always in meters. Yes, we have done for today. See you next lesson, people, on Saturday. All right, on Saturday, please join. Everyone will join, and then we are going to carry on. Have a nice day, people.
Thank you for the lesson, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you, guys.